Hi friends, so in my previous video we learnt about electric current. So I explained the topics, what is electricity, types of electricity, electric charge and its types, and what is meant by current, how does the current flow in conductors, and definition of current. All these topics are explained by me in my previous video. So now we are going to learn that how to measure the current. How to measure the current. So here current is measured with a device called ammeter. Current is measured with ammeter. So here the symbol of this device is simply A, capital A. Ammeter is denoted with capital A. It is in circuit. So we will measure the current with the help of a device called ammeter. So it is denoted with capital A. And one more thing you should remember here. So when we are going to connect the ammeter in the circuit, we should connect the ammeter in series. So in what? This is very very important question. They are going to ask the question like this. How we should connect the ammeter in the electric circuit? So and why? So the answer is that simple. We will measure the current with ammeter. So always we should connect the ammeter in series in the circuit. We should connect the ammeter in series. So why we have to connect the ammeter in series? So there is one reason, isn't it? So what is the reason behind this one means? So in case of series circuit, I will explain regarding series circuit detail. In my next videos, first of all, I want to explain why we are going to connect the ammeter in series. So why? Because in case of series circuit, current remains constant. In case of series circuit, current remains constant. So it does not fluctuate. The current, the value of the current does not change. So we want to measure current. So that's why we have to connect the ammeter in series. So why? Because if the ammeter is connected in parallel, current value will change. So we do not get the proper value. We cannot get the accurate value. For that sake, we need to connect the ammeter in series. So why? Because in case of series circuit, current remains constant. Current remains constant. So that is the reason. And next thing is nothing but ammeter is a low resistance device. It is a low resistance device. So these are the two reasons. For that sake, we should connect the ammeter in series circuit. Okay friends, so our next topic is drift velocity. So drift velocity is denoted with VD. D for drift velocity. What is meant by drift velocity? So in the previous class I explained how does current flow in the circuit, in the wires, in case of conductors. So in that situation, again we are going to remind that particular case here. So here this is nothing but a conductor, it's nothing but copper wire. So here if we connect the cell to the copper wire, all the free electrons are moving in a certain direction with constant average speed. So this constant average speed maintained by the free electrons inside the conductor due to the potential difference applied by the cell is nothing but drift velocity. So once again I am going to explain the drift velocity. The constant average speed maintained by the free electrons inside the conductor due to the potential difference created by connecting the cell to the conductor like copper wire is nothing but drift velocity. So to find the drift velocity, we have one principle here. Drift velocity VD is given by I by NQA. So here I am going to explain the terms here. I means current, already we know that term. So here N means charge density. N equal to charge density. So what is my charge density means? So in general, what is my density? Mass per unit volume. But here quite different here. What is my charge density means? The amount of charge presented in unit volume. The amount of charge present in unit volume. Q means charge per unit volume. So the amount of charge presented in unit volume is nothing but charge density denoted with M. So Q means magnitude of charge. And A means cross-sectional area. So this is the cross-sectional area of the conductor. So this shaded area is representing cross-sectional area. So with the help of this principle, we can find the drift velocity of free electrons inside the conductors like copper, silver and all the metals after connecting the cell to the conductor. So this is nothing but drift velocity. Okay friends, after drift velocity, now we are going to learn about the next topic, potential difference. Our next topic is potential difference. Potential difference is also known as voltage. It is also known as voltage. Both are same here. And potential difference and voltage denoted with the letter V, capital V. So here first of all, before going to know about the potential difference, first just try to observe this diagram, try to learn something from this diagram here. So this is a conductor, already you know that one. So here the magnitude of charge Q. Let us consider a charge, unit positive charge of magnitude Q. And here we are connecting a cell to the conductor. So these are the two terminals of the cell here. So if we connect a cell to the conductor, here there is some difference in the number of electrons here. So if we connect the cell to the conductor, this particular cell create an electric field. It creates electric field to the conductor. It provides the electric field. What is the electric field? For example, if we consider what magnetic field. In case of magnetic field, we will observe north pole and south pole. So what in case of electric field, what will observe? Positive and negative. So if we connect the cell to the conductor, it creates the electric field around the conductor. So due to this electric field, there is some electric force is going to act on free electrons which are presented in the conductors. So here there is some force, we will consider that force as Fe. So that means force created due to the electric field. So this force Fe acts on unit positive, we will consider one charge here, of magnitude Q. So due to the application of this force on the unit charge, it can move to the certain distance. So here the distance covered by the unit positive charge is considered, length of the conductor considered as L. So that means to move this charge, so there is some work is going to be done on the charge. So this work is given by, already we know that work equal to force into displacement. So this is the basic principle of work. So here we need to find the work which is going to be take place on unit positive charge. So here, so work done on the charge is given by, so your force means we have to substitute here this value, force due to electric field. So your displacement is how much distance is going to travel? Distance L. So Fe into L. So this is the principle to find the work which is going to be done on this unit positive charge. So now I am going to explain what is my potential difference. So potential difference means the work done on unit positive charge. The work done on unit positive charge to move it from higher potential to lower potential is nothing but potential difference. I am repeating the definition once again, reason with concentration. The work done on unit positive charge to move it from higher potential to lower potential is known as potential difference. So this is known as potential difference. So that means potential difference is known as V. So according to the definition, work done in simple way, work done on unit positive charge. So that means work per unit charge. So this is the expression to find potential difference. So here what is the value of work here? V equal to W means, instead of W what we need to write here? Fe into L by Q. Right. So this principle is used to find the work done on unit positive charge. So the work done on unit positive charge is nothing but potential difference. So this is nothing but potential difference. So here potential difference, this potential difference is created to the conductor with the help of this cell. So this is the definition of potential difference, and this is the main expression for potential difference, work done on unit positive charge. So now we are going to see what are the units of potential difference. So basically the SI unit of potential difference is, in SI system the units of potential difference is nothing but volt. We will measure the potential difference in volts. So from this equation we can write, so potential difference, SI unit of potential difference is volt. 1 volt will be here. So what is the SI unit of work? Joule. So here we will write 1 joule. So this is charge. What is the SI unit of charge? Coulomb. So this is the equation for 1 volt. So 1 volt equal to 1 joule by coulomb. So now I am going to define how what is the actual meaning of 1 volt. So when 1 joule of work done on 1 coulomb charge to move it from higher potential to lower potential. So then the potential difference between these two points is nothing but 1 volt. So 1 volt equal to 1 joule by 1 coulomb. So once again I am repeating here, what is the actual meaning of 1 volt means, when 1 joule of work take place on 1 coulomb of charge to move it from one point to another point is nothing but its potential difference. Then the potential difference between the two points is nothing but 1 volt. 1 volt equal to 1 joule by coulomb. And next thing, how to measure potential difference? So generally, how can we measure current with the help of ammeter? We can measure the current. In the same way, to measure the potential difference, we have one more device. So its name is nothing but voltmeter. So with the help of voltmeter, we can measure the potential difference inside the circuits. So voltmeter is denoted with V. So that is the symbol for voltmeter. So then how can we connect the voltmeter in the circuit? How can we connect the ammeter in the circuit here? Just now I told, always we should connect the ammeter in series in the circuit. In the same way, voltmeter should be connected in parallel. Always we should connect the voltmeter in parallel in the circuit. So what is the reason for that one here? So the reason is nothing but simple, very simple here. In case of parallel circuit, potential difference will be remains constant. In case of parallel circuit, potential difference will be remains constant. And at the same time, voltmeter is a high resistance device. Voltmeter is a high resistance device. Due to these two reasons, we should connect the voltmeter, always we should connect the voltmeter in parallel. So this is regarding the definition of potential difference, and its unit SI unit is volt, and at the same time, the voltmeter is used to measure the potential difference. So here I want to explain one basics of conductors here. So basically, what is my conductor here? In my previous class I explained here. If any material, if it allows a current due to the existence of maximum number of free electrons, then it is said to be conductor. So conductor means, what is the state of conductor here? Basically conductors are in solid state, but liquid conductors also there. So that means best example is salt water. Salt water means brine solution, scientifically. So if we add some salt to the water, take the salt solution and allow the current, it also start allowing the current. So that means salt water is also conductor, but it is not considered as conductor. It is called as electrolyte. What is it? If any liquid substance, not only salt water, if we consider any liquid substance, if it allows the current, so then that liquid substance is said to be electrolyte. So that is the meaning of electrolyte. So here, in case of conductors, always the current flows with the help of free electrons, movement of free electrons, that means negatively charged particles. But in case of electrolyte, that means liquid, in case of electrolytes, how the current will flow means, so here in case of liquids, the current will flow with the help of the movement of both the ions, positive ions and negative ions. So that is the difference between electrolytes and conductors. You should know these basics regarding the flow of current in case of conductors and electrolytes. So in case of conductors, current will flow only with the help of the moment of free electrons. But if we consider liquids like electrolytes, in case of liquids, the current will flow with the help of the moment of positive ions as well as negative ions. So in this way, flow of current takes place in case of electrolytes. So this is regarding this topic. In this video, I explained about what is meant by current and how to measure the current, what is meant by potential difference, how to measure the potential difference and units of current as well as units of potential difference, and instruments which are used to measure the current time, potential difference, how they should be connected, and drift velocity, expression for drift velocity, and difference between conductors and electrolytes. So these topics are basics of current here. You should know all these topics, and just everyone should remember these topics here. These are all basics only. So you should not forget basics here. So anyway, thank you friends. Thank you for listening to my class. In my next video, I am going to explain about working of battery. How the battery is going to work. How the cell is going to work. Thank you friends. Thank you everyone.